Omaha, Nebraska in 1913, lived with his mother and his stepfather,
and won an athletic scholarship to attend university.
No, schools won't need me anyway.
So he studied for a law degree and graduated.
And?
So active Navy service in World War II.
And?
The return to the Grand Rapids.
And?
And then he was elected to Congress in 1948.
And?
Then in 1965, guess what happened?
He became a White House minority leader.
I have not campaigned either for the presidency or the vice presidency. I have not subscribed to any partisan platform. I am indebted to no man and only to one woman.
His presidency.
Vice President Agnew resigned. The likable Ford was the only candidate acceptable to be the vice president. Despite his wife's protest, Ford accepted the job. After Nixon's resignation, Ford became president of America.
And this was his opening speech.
My fellow Americans, our long national nightmare is over. Our great republic is a government of laws and not men. Here, the people rule.
Ford became the 38th President of the United States on August 9, 1974.
As we bind up the internal wounds of Watergate, more painful and more poisonous than those of foreign wars, let us restore the golden rule to our political process, and let brotherly love purge our hearts of suspicion and of hate.
Some thought Ford was too nice. He was just another regular guy.
Sir, you dropped something.
Well, thank you, sir. Are you the president?
Yes, I am.
Oh, you're nothing special.
His 17-year-old daughter wore jeans in the White House. His son smoked pot, and his wife supported abortion.
This lost many votes. He was the vice president of the United States. They hated him because of his challenge to bold water. And he was a womanizer. After he promised to pay £1 million back to taxes, he wasn't vice president until 4 months later. So Ford had no vice president for 4 months.
Lonely, I'm Mr. Lonely, I have nobody.
Right-wing Ronald Reagan challenged him for the Republican nomination in 1976. Neither of them thought the other was fit to be his president.
I came in like a wrecking ball. I never hit so hard in love. All I wanted was to break your walls. All you ever did was wreck me. Yeah, you wreck me. I put you high up in the...
Nelson Rockefeller as his VP, Ford attacked domestic policy. He managed inflation and unemployment by cutting taxes and spending, and by deregulating certain industries. He and his wife Betty were also vocal about subjects like women's equality, addiction, and even cancer, and this also colored his presidency. Abroad, Ford helped end the Vietnam War, though he was criticized for falling short in terms of aid in South Vietnam. He was also condemned for backing the Helsinki Accords between Western nations and the communists, and for his policy regarding the Panama Canal and later the Indonesian occupation of East Timor. This disapproval may have led to two assassination attempts within a 3-week period in September 1975. Even with his life threatened, Ford ran for president the next year. Though he was ultimately defeated by Democrat Jimmy Carter, Ford was thanked for restoring honor to the White House.
I want to thank my predecessor for all he has done to heal our land.
Ford stayed active in business and politics, even expressing support for the equal rights of gays and lesbians in the new millennium. Unfortunately, his health deteriorated and the 93-year-old died on December 26, 2006. Though many of his decisions were challenged, Gerald Ford proved he was the right man for the job when he took office. Thanks to his personal integrity and honesty, he has ensured a place in history.
Yeah. And won an athletic scholarship to attend university.
No, sports won't need me anyway. You're not supposed to film me. You're supposed to
film me. His background. Why are you not
saying it? I didn't say it. Did you not hear me?
No, you didn't.
I'll say it. Okay. 1, 2, 3.
His background.
Not saying
it. Good enough.
Okay, it's fine.
All your girls do it. My voice is different from all yours. So what's the point? Why don't you not do it?
I'm blue.